if you're like me, and by that I mean you spend way too much time on YouTube researching laundry detergent for your next video, you've probably come across an ad like this one.
Unfortunately, it's really f***ing good. I just wanted to try it. It's something you never think is going to happen to you, and then it does. From the second I started using laundry sauce, the world's best smelling laundry pods, everything changed. Lost my girlfriend, got 4 new ones. I'm so sore. They can't get enough of the Siberian pine. And no, that's not a euphemism. It's the ultimate aphrodisiac. Rugged, sophisticated, and subtle. Once they get a whiff of my sauce, they keep coming. Back to do their laundry at my place. If you value your alone time, don't go to laundrysauce.com.
Laundry Sauce sure has their marketing game down, with ads like this one featuring sexual innuendo, touting the manliness of their scents, and promising a life-changing experience regularly served to me on YouTube and other social media. But what about their pods? Are they any good? Or do they just offer mediocre cleaning power with a surprisingly amazing scent? Today, we'll find out. First, let's take a look at the laundry sauce pods. Through the magic of asking the laundry sauce Instagram account nicely, I was able to purchase this 4-pod sampler, which is not normally available on their website, for just $10.97, which made it possible to do this video without spending $70 on laundry detergent pods. You can see it comes in this nice little black package, which I'm not going to turn around and reveal my address. Pulling it out of the package, you can see that the box that these pods come in is quite sleek and designed nicely as well. It is held closed magnetically, which gives the box a premium feel, and inside you can see it has their two most popular scents, Australian sandalwood and Siberian pine. Please excuse the bad filming angle here, as I must have been slightly drunk the day I filmed this. Here's a slightly better shot of what the pods look like in the package. Along with the laundry sauce, we're going to test out 3 other pods. First is this fresh and clean powder-based pod from Dollar Tree, which works out to about 12.5 cents per pod. The True Living brand pods that are available from Dollar General and work out to be 31 cents per pod. Lastly, we will test the Tide Plus Ultra Oxy pods, which are available for as little as 32 cents each if you buy the 85 pack at Walmart. Now, let's review the stains we will be testing. This is actually the first video in which I added the barbecue sauce to the mix, so I don't yet have a marked slot for it. But in addition to the barbecue sauce, we have hot sauce, ketchup, mustard, soy sauce, coffee, wine, markers, grass, used motor oil, and dirt. As in my previous videos, I applied these in the same way to each sample cloth to try and ensure consistency before allowing them to dry for at least 2 hours, and then put the samples in the dryer to fully cure the stains. Now that the stains have fully cured, it's time to test the detergents, starting with the Dollar Tree pods. The Dollar Tree pods are different from the others because of their much smaller form factor and the fact that they are powdered based, unlike the others, which are liquid based. I put the pod in the washer along with the stain sample, some rags, and a towel. The washer was set to normal load size with warm water and the energy saver turned on. Next up is the True Living Dollar General pods. I put the pod in with the stain sample, rags, and towel, and started the load. Now for the Tide pod. In goes the pod with the stain sample, rags, and towel, and I'll start the load up. Finally, the laundry sauce. In goes the pod with the stain sample, rags, and towel, and I'll start the load. Now that everything has been washed, let's compare the results. I'm using this shot of the stain samples for the comparison because it provides a clearer shot than the video footage of how each pod did. Starting off with the Dollar Tree pod, we can see it did a substandard job, struggling with wine, marker, grass, motor oil, and dirt. It seemed to do a pretty good job on the hot sauce and barbecue sauce, ketchup, mustard, and soy sauce and coffee. I see a little bit of ketchup and mustard there, but it seems like the others it did a fairly good job on that I mentioned. Moving on to the Tide Pod, we can see that it looks like it did a much better job than the Dollar Tree Pod, but it struggled a little bit more with mustard. It did a little bit better on marker, a lot better on grass, and it seems like it did about the same on dirt. Note those little lines on the dirt portion of the Dollar Tree Pod look to be motor oil, but I'm not quite sure about that. Moving on to the True Living Dollar General Pod, it looks like this one really did quite a good job getting all or mostly all of the hot sauce and barbecue sauce, doing pretty good on the ketchup and mustard, completely eliminating the soy sauce, leaving behind a little bit of wine stain, getting the coffee off completely. It looks like this one did the best job on the marker, and maybe slightly worse on the grass. Motor oil seems to be about the same as the rest, and dirt seems to be the best yet. Lastly, let's look at the laundry sauce. Laundry sauce seemed to do well, again with the hot sauce and the barbecue sauce. Seemed to do maybe slightly worse than the True Living Pod on the ketchup and mustard. Looks like it did perfectly well on the soy sauce, the best we've seen on wine, and it got all the coffee off, but most of the other pods did that as well. It did maybe a little bit worse on the marker than the True Living Pod or the Tide Pod, and a little worse on the grass, but the motor oil is still there, and the dirt it looks like it might have done the best on. You can make your assumptions yourself by looking at this image, but that's what I found. In conclusion, I actually thought the laundry sauce pod did surprisingly well on the stains, keeping up with the Tide. I was also surprised by how much the Australian sandalwood scent grew on me during the course of this video. It was actually the first pod I tested, and the fact that the scent stayed in the towels and rags through the subsequent tests was quite surprising. Is it worth paying 3 times more than the other pods? For me, probably not, but I'll leave that value judgment for each of you. It was quite a good scent, though, and I'll be sad when I use up the other 3 pods. Just a reminder that I did buy these pods with my own money and received no sponsorship from Laundry Sauce or any other company, which makes this last part quite important. Your interaction with this video means the world to me as a new creator trying to get monetized so that I can produce more review videos, which can get expensive. So please, like this video, subscribe to the channel, and comment what you'd like to see me test next, or what improvements I can make. Thanks for watching, and I hope to see you next time.